So guys, this is the final chapter, and here we'll composite all the layers. So I'm doing the compositing in Nuke. So we have rendered all the layers. So here is the embers, here is the fire, and here is the scene. So just select all the three layers, drag and drop into the node graph of Nuke. So just select here and press S. So just change here to 1080, and so we'll just see the fire first. So as you can see, I have rendered up to 110 frames. So we'll just take a reformat, and we'll reformat to HD. So if we'll play, so now you can see we are having fire. So now we'll merge. The embers. So just take a reformat. And now everything is fine. So now you can see the embers and the fire are looking nice. So just take a glow node. So it is much bright, so we'll keep it to 0.2. So it is nice. We'll take a color correction. So let's press CC. So we get color correct node, yeah. So here, so now we'll just merge the scene also. Take a reformat. Now we can So now it is looking nice. So you can then adjust again a little bit. You can adjust a gamma. Take a grade. Take a grade node in the embers. So just increase the gain and the multiply. And as you can see, the size is a little bigger, so we can take a E node. We can give it to give some negative values. So let's keep it to -8.6. That's nice. And just increase the gain. I'll keep the multiplication by 5. Increase the gain by 10 or by 7. So now it is looking good. So take another CC and adjust the colors. So you can adjust the colors and so now, and the scene, for scene we'll just put a grid and we'll just light it up a little. So for the background we can keep a constant, we'll merge it, so make the background B for background and A for above. So now just adjust the color towards blue, dark blue. So now this is nice. So but while rendering the scene in Houdini, just keep the pixel sample to 6x6 and minimum ray samples to more than 5, so that you won't get this jitter like thing. So right now you can see we're getting this jitter like thing, so just increase the pixel values and the global values also, so that we won't get jitters. So now this is looking nice, and I'll just try to trick these jitters. So if you just press control, so you'll get the middle to adjust the notes. So I'll bring the roto, so just press O and we'll get a roto. So just mark a roto. So just adjust this and put a blur and mask it, so it won't go totally, but yeah, we can adjust a little bit. You can and we can create a softened node. It softens, so we'll mask it to the roto and so it can soft it. Blur will make it less, not much. And that's how it ends. So just play. So we have got the fire is beautiful, the embers are working very well. So now we can give motion blur also. So now you can see we have motion blur. So if you press D, it deactivates node. You can see the motion blur. So this gives a good look and feel. And now we'll just play and see. So you can see the glow on the tree, it is looking nice. So you can see with the motion blur, the embers are looking good and the fire is also looking good. So you can see now it is looking beautiful and so now we can make this as output. So just create a write node. Go to the file and for output, we'll just go to the. So here I'll just make the output tree fire. _fire.out. So just take H.264 quick type and everything is fine. And just so and you can just start rendering. So make it global so it will render 1 to 110 frames. Press OK. so it will take some time, and it's just going to render it. So now, so got the demo file. So there is some problem. So I might have some problem with the quick time. So yeah, so this way you can write the file, and so we have got beautiful fire, we have got beautiful embers. So this is the output, and so this is it. So we have created fire embers. So that's it for the course, and thank you very much.